Our first stop is with a little company called Micro. This company first started with the question, how much car do you really need for your daily commute? They came up with a machine that rides a fine line between a car and a motorbike. And with that revelation and the inspiration they received from the 1950s bubble cars, the first Microlino was designed and then later manufactured. And from the birth of those magnificent random events coinciding, we then get the next evolution in the form of the Microlino 2.0. Just imagine a world where any empty parking spot is yours for the taking, and you can cross-park due to your ride needing a third of the space of a typical car. Despite its diminutive size, the Microlino still manages space for two adults and up to three beer crates of storage. That's about 58 gallons of premier storage space. Looking at performance, this lightweight 1,130-pound box car expertly utilizes your choice of battery for a range of 78 to 124 miles and a top speed of 56 miles per hour. And if you dawdle over charge times, worry not, for a quick charge up is accomplished in a measly 4 hours with any socket in your home, or even just 1 hour at designated charging stations. The Microlino 2.0 is an artisanally crafted machine for the niche buyer right now, but perhaps we'll see a shift in the future when commuters can no longer deny the appeal of this little guy. Splach made a big splash on Indiegogo, where they got their start with ideal substitutes to cars and other means of transport. They offer premium electric scooters that utilize cutting-edge and user-friendly technology. The Transformer is a fantastic scooter with a somewhat distinctive truss design and durable steel construction. This quick ride may not give the horses a run for their money, but the Transformer boasts an impressive 960-watt peak motor, with the power to go 24 miles per hour. Perhaps more impressive, though, is the 28-mile range the 48-volt battery has. The 28% hill grade doesn't hurt anything either. The Transformer's rear coil shock gives the suspension a hearty boost, as well as cushioning the scooter. That, combined with the 10-inch pneumatic fat tires and mechanical front and rear brakes, make for one smooth ride in all seasons and on all terrain. And no need to fret, the Transformer has a headlight and a rear light for nighttime strolls or graveyard shift employees. The Transformer is a perfect fit for those looking to waste a few hours or those looking to cut back on their inner city commute with an enjoyable alternative.
Hi, I'm Allie, and it's Mind's Eye Trivia Time. By looking at just these images, do you know what this is and where it's from? Leave your answer or your best guess in the comment section below.
3. Next up, we look at a company that can trace its foundations back to 1925 after the real estate boom. Nautique has had a prosperous career constantly innovating the boating scene, and it hasn't seemed to halt. Now, Nautique has an extensive collection of awards from every direction, and they are continuing to push innovation. Good hard work can only go so far. It's the ever-expanding minds like those at Nautique that dare to move us ever forward, inch by inch. So what does all that praise even add up to? Well, the 2021 Super Air Nautique GS22E is more than a mouthful, it's an eyeful. It's also up to the gills with tech, with a Nautique surf system with wave plate technology integrated into the hull. This allows you to create the perfect surfing environment for you and your friends, even in still waters. The Super Air Nautique GS22E was also designed with virtual access in mind. You can monitor the battery charge, location, and other important metrics remotely via the software. This is a first-of-its-kind, revolutionary electric towboat. Nautique has partnered with their sister company, Ingenuity Electric, to implement the latest in electric propulsion to the already wildly popular GS22E. This drive system that Ingenuity devised allows the GS22E to perform at its peak for up to 3 hours on a single charge. We have to mention the charge times. They range from 12 hours to an incredible 1.5 hours on a super fast DC charge. For our second spot, we had to bring back a classic, the Omni Hoverboard. There are a few updates to this up-and-comer that seem rather promising. And for those not so familiar with this one, the Omni Hoverboard is a project Alexandre Duru had conjured, starting with his first electric multi-rotor hoverboard back in 2015. He is now trying to commercialize the super simple 8-rotor design that utilizes snowboarding boots and hand throttle. And that's part of its charm. The Omni Hoverboard is as simple as you could get. It even only uses an open-source Arduino electronics platform to read the throttle and send the information to the rotors. It may not be able to compete with Frankie Zapata's Flyboard Air, which claims a maximum height of 10,000 feet and a flight speed of nearly 100 miles per hour. But it does compete with balance. The hoverboard was able to complete a flight of 905 feet, while the Flyboard Air was able to complete 7,389 feet. Of course, the Omni hoverboard doesn't use kerosene, like the Flyboard Air. It's much more environmentally friendly and offers a quieter ride. And aside from actually designing a relatively user-friendly flying machine, Duru also has to maneuver the legality and logistics of getting something like this in other people's hands. It's challenging to take something like this to a mass market when the dangers are so great. Still, Duru believes slowly through sifting processes these are solvable issues. And while his determination may well be what it takes, even if this may fall more into an extreme sport rather than a mode of transport. Regardless, we love the idea, and we want to see more of it. And with that, we come to our last stop. Before we put the saddle up, though, we want to show you a little treat. Starting as a college project by the University of Applied Sciences of Zurich, Share Your Bicar was initially inspired by the BMW C1. It has since broken off into its own company. Bicar is a lot like a pony rather than a horse. It is small, efficient, and gets you from A to B with zero emissions. The Bicar is weather-protected, keeping you separated from the rain and snow. And don't be misled, this is a transport vehicle through and through. It has room for a single passenger and only enough luggage space for around 2 grocery bags, up to 55 pounds. Despite all that and its size, the Bicar miraculously boasts a 2,000-watt battery, allowing this micro-mare to gallop at speeds up to 28 miles per hour. Perhaps even more impressive are the solar panels on both the front and back of this vehicle, making the Bicar the first electric vehicle capable of being operated solely on solar power. With Bicar's mobile app, you can find charging stations, lock and unlock your Bicar, geolocalize a Bicar, and use your phone as a navigation tool, all while using your already existing tools in your favor. So, who is this unique scooter for? Well, its size, maneuverability, and power make it perfect for those looking for alternatives for your daily commutes. The Bicar can easily navigate a cityscape and the traffic that it would entail. We find it appealing, and with it being a few clicks away and available for worldwide purchase, it is tempting. you see yourself replacing your car with a more environmentally friendly alternative like some shown here today? Or are you looking more for a toy to play with within your sandbox? And if so, which one? Let us know in the comments. We would love to hear your feedback. If you enjoyed this video, you could help us out by hitting the like button, subscribe, and keep up to date on future posts.